the last lecture, we have understand the numericals which are related with the capacity planning. Now, in this lecture, we will understand the next part after capacity planning, that is facility location. First of all, we understand the meaning of the term facility. Facility simply means a plant or a factory which is going to be started in a short span of time, and location refers to a particular place where that factory or a company is going to start its operation. As an example, if we consider Aurangabad, or if we consider Mumbai as location, a company going to start its business. Say for example, company XYZ is going to start its business in Mumbai. So Mumbai will be a location, and facility is the place where they are going to set their office from where they will start doing their business. It is nothing but the meaning of facility location. Basically, what happens is that a person who is doing his business, as an entrepreneur, he faces a lot of problems while selecting a particular site. What are the problems which he generally faces? The general problems which he faces while selecting a particular site is accessible, the problems with the labors, the problems with the infrastructure, the land prices where he is going to start his factory, availability of labor force, proper availability of the resources for doing the business. All these are the factors, or you can say things which need to be considered by a businessman or entrepreneur before starting his business in a particular location, or before setting up his facility at a particular location. So facility location simply means, facility means you can say a company or a factory which is going to be set up at a particular location. Say for example, a textile mill is a facility and a location is a Mumbai where it is going to be set up. Now here one particular point comes into picture, that whilst setting up a factory or a mill in a location, the geographical conditions should also be taken into consideration, whether the geographical conditions are suitable for the product or not. As an example, you can take an example of textile mill. This example I have given in the previous lectures also, but I am repeating it once again because it is applicable here also. Cloth or t-shirt which is produced in a textile mill requires humid atmosphere. So generally what happens is that the textile mills are generally set up at the places where the weather in and around the city is humid. You can take an example of Mumbai, or you go to Chennai, Chennai side, you can go to any places where in India where the weather is humid. Generally the mills are set up, textile mills are set up at the humid locations. Now we will understand what are the different steps in location selection. There are certain steps given which are required for selection of location, that whether we want to set up the business in the country or outside the country. If first you have to select a country that we want to do business or location, do business in India or outside India. After selecting the country, we have to select the region, that whether it is at which part of the country we want to do business. Then we have to select the locality, and then we have to select the exact site. Now if you consider or give a bit of concentration to all these four points, from point number one to point number four, the size is getting reduced. We are reducing the size. Country is the biggest, then the region which is smallest than the country, locality is smallest than the region, and site is smallest than the locality. So the you can say the reach of the reach is decreasing as we are moving from step number 1 to step number 4, from country to region, region to locality, locality to exact site. Now if you move forward, understand the meaning of this points in details. The first thing which we have to understand is whether we have to finalize whether business should be done in India or outside India. You can take an example that nowadays many businesses from Gujarat are expanding or setting up their manufacturing facilities in African countries, because in African countries the labor is very very cheap. It 15 to 20 years back, what was happening India was the main target of the countries having good amount of capital or developed countries. But nowadays what is happening is that the trend is shifting from India to lesser developed countries, like countries in the African region, where many businesses from Gujarat have already set up their businesses there, because labor is cheap there, land is easily available there, they get tax subsidies from the local governments. These are some of the reasons why many of the companies in Gujarat region are shifting their base from Gujarat or India to African countries. Now the second point is selection of region. After selecting a country, as I have given you an example, you have to select the region. Now the basically if you understand there are certain points or certain things which should be taken into consideration while selecting a region of that particular country. As an example, if we understand availability of raw material, the first point, the best example you can take here is if you take the locality of, or if you understand the Indian geographical conditions, mainly in the states of Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, most of the sugar industries are located out of the whole India. Why? Because these two states, that is Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, are the leading producers of sugar canes. Sugar cane in whole India is produced maximum in these two states, that is Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, as a result of which maximum sugar industries are located in these two states, to take the advantage of easily availability of raw materials. You can take an example of this. Now the real question arises that what is the advantage of having nearness to the raw material. The advantages are, as raw material is easily available to you and you are located very near to the raw material, near to the location where raw material is available, so cost of transportation is low. You don't face shortage of materials very often. Raw material is available in abundant. These are some of the advantages. Now if you move forward, next point is nearness to the market. What do you mean by nearness to the market? That if you are located at such a place that market means where, at a place where you are going to sell your goods, is very nearer to you from your business location, it will be much more beneficial to you rather than having a base away from the market. What you can do is you have to understand is that market nearness is one of the very crucial or important factors while selecting a particular region. Now second comes is availability of power is, if you understand availability of power, if you take an example of coal, which is one of the sources of power for iron industry and steel industry. If you consider iron industry or steel industry, this is a bit of technical thing, but try to understand this. If you consider iron industry and steel industry, I'm giving you an example so that the point is clear. If you consider iron industry and steel industry, coal is the main source. So the factory factory where iron is produced or some processing is done on iron, or a steel factory, should be selected or should be located nearer to the coal fields. Cold coal fields, nearer to coal fields. As an example, you can take example of Jamshedpur location in India. Tata has maximum amount of setup over there. Tata Steel has maximum amount of setup in Jamshedpur. Why? Because coal is easily available there in India, if you take an example of India. Now the next point which comes is transport facilities. Transport facilities means facilities available for easy movement of goods from one place to another place. You can take an example of rails, roads, water transport means moving the goods from one location to another location. There are many nowadays what happening is that to develop a particular region, the local government is giving good amount of subsidies or proper or very good infrastructure to the companies, so that companies can come there, invest in that particular region, so that particular region will also get developed, and the local people will also get certain work for their hands, and employment of that particular area will increase. So transport facilities also plays a very, very important role for selection of the region. Now, suitability of climate. I have given you this example in the previous part only. This example is repeated once again here. Now I will give you a different example. If you take an example of jute textile, it is certain type of textile only. It is mainly produced in Kolkata in India only, because the weather of Kolkata is very humid, more humid than the other parts of India. And if you want to produce jute textile, the climatic conditions or geographical conditions of Kolkata is the most suitable for producing this jute textiles. The next point which comes is government policy. As what do you mean by government policies? It simply means, in simple terms, if you understand, policy of the government towards the development of the business or to the development of the economy as a whole. Because as more and more companies and more businesses will come in India or will come in a particular country, the economy will grow, the employment will grow, and the country will make development. So what are the government policies, or what are the policies of the government, or what are the things they are doing to attract the foreign investment into that particular country? These policies include the tax rate policies of the government, the subsidies they give to the businesses they are coming, the license clearing policy of the government, how fast the company gets license to enter into that particular region and start doing their operations. All these things comes under the government policy, if you understand. Now, after this, the third point which comes here is selection of community is also very, very important role, plays very important role in facility location. What do you mean by selection of community? Selection of community means is nothing but we have to select such a place for doing business where labor is available at a cheaper rate if you are going to start a manufacturing industry. See, if you understand, it is a very clear-cut economics that if you are going to start a manufacturing industry, it requires more capital as compared to a service industry. Service industry requires only some setup of huge setup of internet, some PCs and tables, cafeteria, nothing more than that. But if you understand, if you are going to start manufacturing of any particular thing, it requires everything, right from machineries to labors to different licenses, different setups. What I mean to say is the investment amount in for manufacturing is very, very high as compared to service industry. So you have to select a site in such a way that labor should be easily available to you. Now, next point which comes here is civic amenities of workers. What do you mean by civic amenities? Civic amenities simply means that the workers, what are the facilities which the company is giving to the workers apart from the working conditions, like whether they have certain clubs of workers where they can go and regenerate themselves, whether there are some theaters or some parks where they can go and do some fitness program, so that their motivation level will be high and they can again come to work with a high motivation and confidence level. So it simply means that what facilities the company is providing other than the working conditions to the workers. The next point which comes is existence of complementary and competing industries. What are the existence of complementary and competing industries? It simply means what? First of all, you have to understand the meaning of complementary and competing industries. Competing industries means a particular business is done by more than one company, and complementary simply means complementary certain means that in a particular location there are more than one type of industries. So as an example, if you take an example of Pune has automobile manufacturing, automobile as a manufacturing setup, it has IT industries, it has KPOs. So what I want to say is if a particular location has more than one type of industries, they are complementary to each other. This is the simple meaning of complementary. Now the next point which is coming here is availability of water and firefighting facilities. There is not much explanation in this particular point. Water should be easily available. Water is the thing which is the most important or essential thing, if you understand, for doing any business. So availability of water plays a very, very important role. And the next important thing is firefighting facilities. Firefighting facilities, as you know, that its government has made it compulsory for every company who is starting their operations or for constructing big buildings to have proper firefighting facilities at every, you can say, floor. So they should have firefighting facilities, and the persons working on those floors, company should design a training program for all the employees, which should be made compulsory to all the employees who are working on that particular floors, so that if in case some fire occurs in that particular region or in that particular vicinity, every person should be able to handle it. What I mean to say is every person or every employee should at least have basic knowledge of what should be done and what should not be done if the fire occurs in that particular region. They should have basic knowledge. That's what I want to say here. The next point comes here is selection of site. What do you mean by selection of site? It includes different things, that the geographical conditions, the standard of living of that particular area, everything comes under this selection of site. Whatever points we have discussed above, all are coming under this particular selection of site. This is all about the facility location. I hope you like my video. Thank you.